How much do you know about hyperpigmentation? Niacinamide, vitamin C, retinol, and more. Our brightening solution for everyone starts now. Hey guys, welcome back to Wish Trend TV. It's your sister Eunice here. Really happy to see you guys. Have you ever worried about skin imperfections such as jowl skin or blemishes? If so, this special series will be the answer for you. This series is Wish Trend TV versus hyperpigmentation. In the very first episode, we will be talking about internal treatments for hyperpigmentation. And in the second episode, we will talk about external treatments for hyperpigmentation. Don't forget to subscribe to Wish Trend TV and follow us on our Instagram as well. Let's begin. Round one, what is hyperpigmentation? To put it in a simple way, hyperpigmentation appears when our skin produces more melanin than usual. Melanin is produced by the melanocytes, which are located at the lowest layer of our epidermis. And during this process, certain factors cause melanocytes to produce more melanin than usual, making the skin darker than it originally was. Causes of hyperpigmentation are number one, sun exposure. So UV rays speed up melanin production, like sunspots, sun freckles, and etc. are some examples. Number two is hormones. Changes in certain hormone levels can cause hyperpigmentation. An example would be freckles that can often be found on women going through pregnancy. Third one is skin injuries and inflammation. The most common example would be acne. You know how after acne heals, pigmentation appears in the spot where the acne was? Like acne, skin injuries and imperfections can darken and discolorate the skin. Next one is age. When the skin ages, the number of melanocytes decreases, but the size of the remaining melanocytes become larger. This causes melanin to be more focused on certain parts of the skin. This is why age spots appear often on older people. Hyperpigmentation doesn't only appear in limited areas. It can appear in smaller areas or cover a large part of the skin. It can even affect the whole body. We can think of hyperpigmentation as a state, when our skin is darker than its original color, meaning that our skin tanned in the summer, or freckles are also types of hyperpigmentation. Hyperpigmentation is not an ailment, so if you're currently happy with your skin, there's nothing wrong with that. However, if you are looking for a solution for hyperpigmentation, the answer to your concern is brightening. Brightening products all take part in taking care of hyperpigmentation. So what are the brightening ingredients that are effective for hyperpigmentation? Let's find out together. Round two, internal treatments for hyperpigmentation. We've divided brightening products into two categories depending on what they do, internal treatments and external treatments. In this episode, we're going to talk about internal treatments for hyperpigmentation. Now, there is a protein called tyrosine found inside the melanocytes that produce melanin. If the skin gets overly stimulated by the UV rays, tyrosinase enzymes oxidizes the tyrosine that is in the melanocytes. The oxidized tyrosine produces melanin, and the skin cells that have this melanin rises up to the epidermis. It takes approximately 30 days for the skin cells to come up. These are the brightening ingredients that internally prevent this process from occurring inside the cells. First, let's learn about alpha-arbutin and vitamin C, which prevents the activation of tyrosinase. Arbutin is an ingredient made by reacting a substance called hydroquinone, which is effective for brightening but has many side effects and glucose. Arbutin has less side effects compared to hydroquinone and is much safer to use. Alpha-arbutin prevents skin pigmentation and is great for brightening effects. It also has a strong antioxidant effect, so it is very effective for aged skin as well. Vitamin C is a very well-known brightening ingredient. Cosmetic products that contain vitamin C have ascorbic acid, which is purified vitamin C, and the sodium ascorbyl phosphate, which is a stabilized derivative. While purified vitamin C has a very strong brightening and antioxidant effect, it also has the possibility of irritating the skin and become unstable when exposed to the heat and the UV rays. On the other hand, vitamin C derivatives have a lower efficiency compared to purified vitamin C, but they are much safer to use. If you have sensitive skin, look for products that have vitamin derivatives. Next, let's learn about vitamin E, which prevents tyrosine from oxidizing. Vitamin E is an excellent antioxidant. It brightens the skin and protects it from stresses such as sun exposure or air pollution. On top of that, vitamin E strengthens the skin barrier and provides moisture by soothing the skin as a natural anti-inflammatory ingredient. Lastly, let's learn about niacinamide and retinol, which suppresses the production of melanin cells. Try using niacinamide, which is a brightening ingredient that is safe and has a lower risk of causing side effects. Niacinamide is a type of vitamin B3 and is also effective in preventing breakouts and improving the skin barrier. It's a mild ingredient that can be used on any skin types. The second one is retinol. Also known as vitamin A, it's also a brightening ingredient. It increases oxygen supply to the skin, speeds up cell metabolism, and pulls the skin cell's turnover cycle forward. It also disperses melanin to improve skin discoloration and dark spots. There are so many brightening ingredients that are effective on hyperpigmentation. So how do we use these ingredients to use them to the best of their ability? Also, are they safe to use at the same time? Let's find out together. Round 3, how to mix and match internal working brightening ingredients. Did you guys know that all ingredients that I've mentioned today are antioxidants? Antioxidants' biggest effect is that it protects our skin from free radicals that are produced by UV rays and the air. It's more effective to apply antioxidant ingredients in the morning because we're exposed to free radicals during the day. The one exception is retinol. Retinol becomes unstable when exposed to light, so we recommend applying it at nighttime rather than in the morning time. And if you are planning to use the ingredients I've mentioned on their own, you don't have to worry about anything. However, if you want to use two or more brightening ingredients together, there are two things that you have to check beforehand. First one is the pH level. Now, check the product's pH level. All the ingredients have their own unique pH level, and they usually are. The first one is elva-arbutin. It's around 4.9. And the second one is niacinamide, which is 5 to 7. And the next one is retinol, which is 5 to 6. And then the next one is vitamin C, which is 2 to 3. And then we have, lastly, vitamin E, which is 6 to 8. Even if they are of the same ingredient, the pH levels may vary by the product. So make sure that you double check on the product's label or on their website. So if the two products that you're using have larger pH level difference than 1 to 2, we recommend applying them with a 30-minute term in between each product, rather than applying them back to back. Now, the second one is water-soluble or oil-soluble. You guys know that oil and water don't mix, right? If you apply oil first, water won't be able to absorb into the skin. So make sure you apply your water-based products before applying your oil-based products. First one is water-based. You have alpha-arbutin, niacinamide, and vitamin C. And the second one is oil-based. You have retinol and vitamin E. Follow these rules and brighten your skin effectively and also safely. These are brightening ingredients that work better when used together. The first one is vitamin C and vitamin E. Vitamin C and vitamin E is one example. Oil-based vitamin E will prevent the water-based vitamin C from oxidizing and will increase its ability to penetrate into the skin. The interactions of the two vitamins are not only effective for brightening, but also for anti-aging as well. Second one is niacinamide and retinol. Niacinamide and retinol are also ingredients that are great when used together. Niacinamide's soothing effect and skin barrier protection eases the skin's inherent response, minimizing side effects caused by retinol. Alright guys, so today we learned about what hyperpigmentation is and the brightening ingredients that internally work to prevent it. Next time, we will learn about how to care for melanin that has already shown up in the skin's outer layer. So please stay tuned in, Wish Trenders, and we will see you in the next one. Bye!